People tend to think the game developers know everything. So when I ask them, why don't you try to do this? Why don't you try making a game? They always seem to respond, I can't do that. I don't know how. Well, neither do we. Today, what I want to talk about is just a few of the ways that we game developers learn how to do something. What I did was I studied games. It's important to point out that playing a game is not the same as studying it. Studying it is a lot more systematic and it's a lot more dull. Now, a few upfront hints. You should usually start with an old game. Older games tend to be much more visible in the way they do things, which means if you start with an old game, you can see how they do it, and then you can move to a newer game and a newer game and see the little jumps that they make. It'll be much easier to follow one step at a time. Games are designed to look real when you're playing a certain way, but the rules become much more clear once you stop playing by their rules. For example, in order to learn Traffic AI, I went to Driver for the Game Boy Color. The first thing I did was I started to follow cars. Nothing else. I just drove slowly, not causing collisions, and I followed cars. I began to notice that every single car turned the same direction. This car turns right, and then the next car turns right, the next car turns right. Right there, I suspected that I understood what was going on, but I couldn't be sure. So I pulled off to the side of the road and I watched traffic. And sure enough, every car that pulls up in this one lane always turns right. The car that pulls up in this one always drives straight. Seeing this behavior tells me that it was not artificial intelligence in the cars, but built into the roads. The roads control traffic. Keep in mind, I played that game a lot as a kid. And I never realized these things because I was too busy playing the game. To check how much it resembled the Game Boy game, I parked on the street corner and I started to watch cars. Unlike the Game Boy one, I noticed, hey, wait a minute, this car turns, this one goes straight, so those rules are no longer apparent here. So what I did was I started to follow a car to see what does he do. I didn't notice anything. He just kept driving along. Everything seemed fine. I stopped. I watched traffic a little more. I see a car turn right. I start to follow this car, and he turns right. And I follow the car, and he turns right. And he turns right. And he turns right. And what this told me is that unlike the Game Boy, the cars actually have a little bit of AI built in so that certain cars will turn, giving the appearance of intelligence. Nobody in their right mind is going to be following that car. You won't stick around long enough to see that that car always turns. First thing I did was I built road tiles, actual building blocks that I can build my roads out of. Reason I'm doing this is because I have 30 days to build this entire project, and that's not much time. Having a tile-based road system will be the fastest way that I can make something. I can even randomize the road systems and create a unique city each time. But what this also let me do was build invisible blocks onto each lane. It'll hit these invisible arrows that just tell it to take this turn or to drive down this way. So all the cars actually do is they hit an arrow, they follow the arrow. Once they hit another arrow, they turn and they follow that arrow. And because I'm building these arrows inside of the tile itself, every new road tile I put down, the car already knows how to deal with it. Yes, the AI is that simple. But it doesn't need to be more complicated because the Ecto-1's going to be flying through traffic. He's not going to stick around long enough to notice the rules. And many things in game design are exactly like this. They look extremely complicated, hard to track, until you spend a little bit of time studying it, and you'll notice that there are very simple rule systems that are hidden because the player isn't looking for them. The player is playing the game.